I want to welcome and introduce to you Eduardo Diaz. He is the director of the Smithsonian Latino Center. The Latino Center supports this program and many others that we do here. We work together with them a lot. We value that partnership a great deal. So please welcome Eduardo Diaz. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Buenas tardes. Gracias por su presencia. Nos da mucho gusto que nos acompañan esta tarde para este concierto de Tony Luján y Sherelle Cassidy. It's really going to be an amazing concert. We're thrilled always to work with the National Museum of the American Indian on programs such as this. The reason, I think, is because there's so much that unites us, Latinos and indigenous peoples, and you're going to see it represented here this afternoon. We're thrilled that Sherelle Cassidy and Tony Luján have put together this amazing, amazing band. This is also part of Jazz Appreciation Month. I hope some of you have picked up programs as you were coming in for Jazz Appreciation Month. We kicked it off on Thursday at the National Museum of American History with a wonderful tango jazz concert by Pablo Aslan. So this is just the beginning, and we hope that you'll come back for more, and you've got a complete schedule. Sherelle Cassidy, recent album, Relentless, by the way, Relentless is also for sale. After this, I'm sure you'll rush to get it. Just got a really nice rating from Downbeat Magazine. She performs frequently with the Dizzy Gillespie All-Star Band. In fact, she just finished a performance at Lincoln Center in New York. And also a special thanks as well to Tony Luján, who's the trumpet player here, who is from Albuquerque, New Mexico. Any New Mexicans in the house? Here we go, from the Navajo Nation. Yes, he's, you know, you're trying to figure out, okay, what's the connection between Albuquerque and sort of like Cuban music? Then we realize, well, of course, Tony is part Jicarilla Apache, and where's like a major town close to the Jicarilla Reservation? Cuba, New Mexico, right? So no, so it's sort of like maybe by osmosis or a strange coincidence or something. He's also part Isleta Pueblo, which is the pueblo that's just south of Albuquerque. There are 19, actually, pueblos in the state of New Mexico. And so the correlation between Latinos and Native Americans in the state of New Mexico is a very close one. There's even the Nacaydine, you know, the Mexican clan in the Navajo reservation as well. So there's very, very close ties that unite our people oftentimes. He also is the producer of an album called Tribute, which is also for sale as well. And as you read in your brochure, they are joined by an amazing, amazing band from New York, by way of all kinds of places, Puerto Rico and so forth, and Cuba. The Terry Brothers, you'll meet them, and Richie Flores. Some of you maybe have been piddling around with the conga drums once in a while. This guy is going to hurt your feelings big time, but he's absolutely amazing. It's a wonderful band that is put together, and you'll meet them all. We're also very happy to welcome Eladio Terry as well, who's related to two of the band members here. And he's joining us in a very special treat. He's played with many, many bands in Cuba, including Maravillas de la Florida from Camagüey. In this summer, the museum's going to be presenting an exhibition entitled Up Where We Belong, an exhibition about Native American musicians working in popular American music genres. So we invite you to come back more and more here to the National Museum of the American Indian. It will include musicians like Oscar Pettiford, Mildred Bailey, and Russell Moore. And of course, it wouldn't be the Smithsonian without me also encouraging you to learn more about this music. This is an educational institution, what can I say? I encourage you to read a couple of books here, including one entitled The Birth of Bebop by Scott DeVoe, if you want to learn more. Dizzy Gillespie, this is a tribute to Dizzy Gillespie and Oscar Pettiford, as you know. Dizzy was really, you know, the leader in the bebop movement, and he wrote a book entitled To Be or Not to Bop. So look for that. Leonard Acosta's book, Cubana B, Cubana Bop, the introduction of Chano Pozo, who Dizzy Gillespie welcomed to the band, sort of led this introduction of Cuban music and Cuban rhythms that you're going to see with a chequere that's going to be played by Don Eladio. So you'll see how this meshed And this is a wonderful, wonderful work that you'll see here. But it's the whole the Cubana Bop movement was something that Dizzy Gillespie spearheaded. I also see that our friend Larry Applebaum is here. How many of you listen to WPFW? All right. Sound of surprise. Larry, raise your hand so they know who the man behind the mic is. Larry's been a great supporter of jazz throughout the city. His program is actually at from 4 to 6 every Sunday, WPFW 89.3 FM. I encourage you to listen and then stay tuned because Latin Flavors after Larry spells his magic, does his special work. He's always got great new stuff on there. For more information about Jazz Appreciation Month, I encourage you to visit the website here at the Smithsonian. It's www.smithsonianjazz.org, and you can learn all about Jazz Appreciation Month. Well, enough of that. How about we welcome to the stage Tony Lujan and Sherelle and her group, and we get on with this incredible music. Thank you very much for coming. Buenas tardes. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. so much. Consuélate como yo, que yo también tuve un amor y lo perdí. Consuélate como yo, que yo también tuve un amor. Oh yeah, y lo perdí. Y por eso digo ahora, ya yo no vuelvo a querer. Señor, ¿de qué me sirvió el querer si a mí también me traicionó? Oh yeah, como a ti. Por eso ahora, ya yo no vuelvo a querer. Ya yo no vuelvo a querer, cariño. Ya yo no vuelvo a querer.
Por eso ahora, ya yo no vuelvo a querer.
Ya yo no vuelvo a querer, madre. Ya yo no vuelvo a querer.
Por eso ahora, ya yo no vuelvo a querer.
Una cosa dice el hombre, la otra la mujer. ¿Qué dice?
Por eso ahora, ya yo no vuelvo a querer.
Ya yo no vuelvo a querer, madre.
Thank you. Thank you. great band. Thank you. That was an Oscar Pettiford composition. He's also a bassist from Oklahoma, and I also happen to be from Oklahoma, so I'm proud of that. And living in New York City now, I'd like to play a composition next called Song of Those Who Seek. It's one of my original compositions on my new album, Relentless. So I'd like to invite Conrad Herwig and Yosvani Terry back to play Song of Those Who Seek with me.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank a few important people here at the National Museum of the American Indian. I'd like to thank the directors of the museum, Kevin Gover and Eduardo Diaz. Also, Joan Stevens, Howard Bass, Arriviva Amos, and Margaret Sagan. Thank you. To complete the program, I'd like to bring out Tony Lujan, and we'd like to finish with a song I hope all of you know by Dizzy Gillespie. Thank you, and have a great evening.
Thank you. Pancho. Rechito Flores de la Conga. Josvani Terry and tenor saxophone. My brother, Conrad Herrig, on trombone. The best living piano player on earth, Mr. Itzo Gomez. Josvani Terry, Junior Terry, on bass. And my dear friend here, the master of the drums, Horacio El Negro Hernandez. Yeah, my name is Tony Luan. I thank you so much. To Dizzy, oh, excuse me, Sherelle Cassidy on alto. Very special thanks to Dizzy Gillespie and Oscar Pettiford, and especially to Barbara Sagan. Thank you so much. And my dear wife, Liliana Shena. Thank you. Peace.